And Appsgeyser is brilliant because it takes you step by step how to do this on which chosen platform. So it's going to give you a couple of options. The first option here is publish to Google Play. If you already have a Google Play account, you can go ahead and log into that. If not, you will have to set up an account, and it'll tell you the benefits and the cons, I guess. There is a $25 charge, one-time registration fee from you have to pay to Google just to set up your account. If you don't want to do that, there are other options. There's these four options here. And since I already use Amazon anyway, I'm going to use the Amazon App Store. But if you want, you can go ahead and set up a quick account and start publishing your apps on the App Store. So for this, I'm going to go ahead and select the App Store. It's going to take me to this page here. Now, before we do anything, so before we go on to Amazon, there is a few things that we can prepare. So again, I'm going to attach those screenshots. I'm not sure why it didn't save it, but just attach those screenshots again. So once I uploaded the icon, it's now created a smaller icon for us, which we will need later on as well. Now we've done that, we can go on to the next step. Now it's telling us to write a short description, so you actually do need to make sure you write a short description. So let's do that now. Now we need to write a longer description. Yeah, I can't really think of anything right now, but you can go ahead and put some more effort into it. The better you write your descriptions, the more attractive the game will look to people when they're looking at it. Again, make sure you write 5 bullet points of the benefits of this game, I guess. So choice of tiles, traditional Mahjong game, and magical theme. I'm scraping the bottom of the barrel for this information, but again, make sure you spend more time doing this. So now we have this, we can move on. Now it's telling you to create a developer account, so go to Amazon developer homepage. It says link here, or you can go to and log into it if you already have an account, which I do, so I've already signed into it. But it's telling you to do that, say it's showing you how you can create an account as well. So I'm going to say I have an account. Now let's go ahead and publish it to the App Store. So now we need to go over to the Amazon App Store. So once we've logged into the developer console, this is on the dashboard, we can go to apps and services, and then it will show you any apps that you've already published or submitted. Then we want to go ahead and upload a new app. And as you can see on the over here, it'll tell you step by step what you need to do. So we need to add Android next, and then we need to add the category. I mean, it's fairly simple. You could go along with this up until a point yourself. So let's just go next. So now it's going to ask us for the application title. So this is only a demo. I'm not actually going to publish this. I've already published the actual full version, which you can check out. I'll throw a link in the description. But let's go ahead and finish this off. The app SKU, we don't need to worry about. It's something to do with Amazon. The app category, let's make sure we set this to games. We can set the subcategory to, I'm not sure, it'll probably be strategy, would it? Would it be? I think it would be strategy or board games, something like that. App features, it's a casual indie game. It's not multiplayer, it's not widget, it's not live. Customer support contact, let's go ahead and leave a contact. Just in case. I'm not going to put a phone number, or you could put your website. I'm going to put the Facebook group. I'm just going to say this. So now it's going to go to the next step. And if you want to follow along with here, we can go ahead and follow along. But now this is the first page done. Let's go to the next page, availability and pricing. So now this is pretty simple. Do you want to make it a free application or do you want to make it paid? If you make it paid, before you can actually submit it finally, you will need to update your, tax information, I guess. If you want to make it free, you can go ahead and do that and you don't need to worry about anything else. Again, for this example, I'm going to make this free, but if you wanted to make it paid, you can go and do that. Then set the price, and you can also make sure it's calculated in all the different marketplaces as well. So let's save this. So now it's asking for the information that we wrote down before. So if we go back to Appsgeyser and we go down here, it's giving us the things we can just copy and paste. So Control C, Control V, same thing for this one and for this one. And you can add some keywords as well. So just copy and paste these. Make sure you save that. Then images and multimedia. So now it's asking for the icons. So go back to Appsgeyser. And here's the screenshots. If we want to download them, we just click this and download them. But since I already have them, there's no need to do that. The small icon and the large icon, if we want to, we can download these now. We already had the large icon, which was 512 by 512, which I already uploaded to the site. Then it's created a smaller icon since it knows that Amazon needs the smaller one as well. So make sure you download the small icon. We can go ahead and upload the small one. Same thing for the screenshots. Go ahead and upload the screenshots. Go ahead and click save. And what we can do as well, we can preview how it would look. It doesn't look too bad. Now we can move on to the next page. Content rating. This is just to declare if there's any violence or cartoon violence, drugs, nudity. Just need to make sure you select the correct content rating. Otherwise it will get flagged and it will be penalized, I guess, or took down. So just to make sure you select the right one, the correct ones. Again, make sure you read these as well. Depending on what app you're creating, it may or may not be different for these settings. So, no, we don't collect any personal information. No, there's no advertisements. It's not aimed at people under 13. There's no gambling. No, there's no location-based services. No, there's no generated content or user-to-user communication. Privacy policy. So it's required if your app collects personal information. I guess you don't really need to do this, but if you want to, Appsgeyser gives you a link, so you can, if you go down here, gives you a link, you can go ahead and copy this and use their privacy policy. So that's very useful. Go ahead and paste this in, save that. And then finally, we go to the last step, which is actually uploading the APK files. Go back to Appsgeyser. Go down here. Step 9 is upload the APK. So we need to select this here where it says APK. This is actually your application. So then it should start downloading, I guess. If it doesn't, you just need to follow the instructions on screen. So now it started to download here. Once it's done, I'm just going to go to show in folder and then just copy it to a folder with all my other assets. So that's your APK file. Make sure you know where you've saved this to, because we need to upload this now. So since we've got this, which is great, thanks very much, get rid of it. Let's go back to Amazon. Now it's asking us to apply a DRM, which is protection. Yes, we definitely want it APK file. Let's go ahead and upload that. Again, make sure you know where you saved this. So this is what your APK file looks like. Go ahead and open it. This may take a little bit longer depending on how big the file is. So I'm just going to let that go through. Language support. If it's in different languages, go ahead and select the language that it's supporting. Export compliance. You need to make sure you read this. It's just telling you, it's just asking if it's okay to import and export to the US and other countries that Amazon operates in. Again, make sure you read everything. Then once this is fully uploaded, you can go and click save. Once that's done, it will then either take you to the dashboard or it will add a new a tab here. Just click the new tab so you can go ahead and click that and then submit it. Once you've submitted it, it will take, I think less than 24 hours. It will give you a message and tell you exactly how long it will take and when it will be uploaded, providing that it passes the inspection or the guidelines, I guess. And if we go to the final example, what we just created, this is what it will look like with these screenshots. So when it first gets uploaded, it might say image not available, but then after a few hours, all these started to show. So don't worry if it says image is not available. In the end, it will show up. So there we go. We've created an app. I'm not sure how long that took, but it's very quick, very simple. Most importantly, it's free, and you can start making money from this if you make this as a paid download. But if you guys want to check this out, I'll throw a link in the description and you can check this application. It's absolutely free. So if you want to go ahead and download this, try it out, and maybe give me some feedback. Let me know how it works. But if you guys use Appsgeyser to make some awesome apps, make sure you leave a link in the comments below. Or if you want to go to our Facebook group and post it there, by all means, it's great to check out what you guys are creating. Hopefully you found this tutorial helpful. If you did, be sure to give it a like. And as always, thanks for watching.